Peruvian poverty is a mixture of two styles of poverty: Europeans and the indigenous Ojibwe people who are already in Detroit. The mixture of those two styles is Peruvian poverty. Right.
Stand next to Jamal.
Now, what is this picture? Native Americans here, indigenous people, white folks. This white woman and her two kids. That's Lady Marie Calice de Cadillac. Her arrival less than a year after her husband founded Fort Pontchartrain du Détroit. So she comes months after him and lives inside the fort. Marie Calice de Cadillac. Remember, I said they were trading with the French, and they were coming to bring some furs, and one of the Frenchmen's dogs attacked one of the Ojibwe, attacked one of the warriors who were coming in to trade. One of the Frenchmen, their dog bit him, and he kicked the dog. I mean, that's what you're gonna do, the dog bites, don't kick the dog, and the French soldier killed the Ojibwe warrior, kicking the dog. Of course, that started a war between the Ojibwe and the French. They killed dozens of Ojibwe because of this. This is just there were numerous breakouts that we don't call wars today, but that's really what they were between the French. So, because in a trade relationship, it's always, the Europeans were always trying to get over. So sometimes the Native Americans would get mad. You may have heard of Pontiac's Rebellion. That was one of those time periods when the indigenous people, like, we going all in. And they killed a whole bunch of Europeans, but they lost. Pontiac was not able to defeat the British. In that case, the British wasn't able to defeat them. But he killed a bunch of them.
Not enough.
Right. And of course, he ended up being killed himself by a fox tribesman. They got him drunk and then killed him outside of a saloon. February this year.
Hello, my name is Carl Grigsby, and I'd like to direct my question to Mr. Felipe. What country are you originally from?
Originally? Africa. But, no, I was born in the United States, in Cincinnati, Ohio. I guess you asked me that because of my name. And that comes from a history of my family. When back in slavery times, they went to Mexico to escape slavery, so all my family.